this is an opportunity for you to sharpen your sword. If anybody have anything to shout about, it's us and them and you. Amen. So I thank God for all of the texts, the calls, the well wishes, everybody that came to our home and put on masks and wade through everything that you had to go through to get to us. I just want to let you know that I thank my children, our three children, especially our youngest son, you know, who said, "Mom, I don't care, I'm coming to get you. Dad, I'm going to get you. I'm going to come." No matter how we encourage him not to do it, he found some friends with a kayak. He said, "I'm coming." Church family, you'll hear about that later. I'm not here to glorify anyone but the Lord Jesus Christ, the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, and He is faithful. And you know, we've been talking about moving day, amen, moving forward, going forward. Pastor been talking, and I'll let him share a little bit. But you need to know that God is more than able to bring us through this. And may I, given to Pastor Gordon and the First Lady, I want you to know that this too shall pass. This is just another opportunity for us to shine like never before. And if you've never been through anything, how can you have compassion? How can you have love? How can you have just mercy and grace upon you if you've never been through anything? And I'm so excited to stand here, and I want to tell you that God is so faithful. I'm telling you that God is so good. And this too, what we're going through, we're going to get to the other side of the show. So I just really want to urge you, as I get ready to pass the mic to my husband, I just want to urge you, really, it's critical time now that you shout, that you give God the praise, you give God the glory. We got to not walk by what we see, and truly, I have seen a lot, and we've been through a lot, my husband and I, but you can't go by what you see. And each day, and as we can attest to you, it does get better each day. Now you go through your human emotion columns, you're going to go through your human emotions, but because that's just normal. You need to grieve those things, but then you move on and you start looking ahead. We press toward the mark of our higher life. We just welcome you here. We love you. And I know our Pastor Ray, our associate pastor, is going to bless you. We just want to just chill out. Pastor Gordon, you want to come and address? Come on, First Lady. But I'm going to give it my husband. Y'all come address your congregation. Come on.
After the fourth day was over, and then they released me, I finally got some relief. And on my way home, I had to take all kind of back roads because of water. This flood, I had to go through some water. I never saw how the freeways was flooded. It just amazing. I just shook my head. And the Lord allowed me to get 3 miles from home. And I said, I got a choice. Go back to work, stay in this car, or tread the waters and go home. So I had my rain gear and everything on. And I said, I'm going to walk. Get out of this water and walk home. And as I walked through the water, the rain was just coming down. I had my gear on. And I thought about this woman here. I said, I'm treading the water. And I was walking through the water, and I walked over this bridge, and I walked through the water, and put your head up on the board, and walk through the waters, yes. Shall not be overflowed. Yes. Amen. And so I got right there in the middle of the water, and a big old truck came by. And he stopped in the middle of the water while I was in. And he said, get in. Yes. I said, man, I'm so nasty and I'm dirty that I don't want to get in your truck, but I get in the back. So I laid his tailgate down, and I jumped up in there. He took me as far as he could take me. And I walked the rest of the way. But I thank God that he provided for me. I have no complaints of what took place, and I just thank God that no lives were lost. And even, I don't want to take too much of the time, but on Saturday, I just spent just going through the neighborhood ministering to people because I felt what they felt. And as I ministered to people that was going to a clinical therapy, they needed someone to just hear what they had to say. Because that was something, so I lost everything. I don't have anything left but the clothes on my back. They need to listen to hear and someone to pray with them, someone to give them hope because their hope was damaged. And as I began to minister to them and as I left the neighborhood, they had hope, they had a smile on their face. I would go from one place to another. Hurt that they was feeling, and I was able to minister to them that they had hope. So that was something that was felt like giving up. But as we give them hope, that's our job, to give people hope. So we just have today what God is doing, and we'll ask it back and just thank God for the members of Haven Refuge, how they pitched in and came over to the church. They began to tear walls down, pull up carpet, pull flooring up, and all of those things. And we just had members to come together. That was members we hadn't seen for a long time. They were there. And God has a way of bringing us together. We witness and thank you for that.
Well, hello, Haven Refuge. Hello, Restoring Hope. And I want you to know, I feel no ways tired this morning. God has gone too far from where I started. Nobody told me that this road would be easy. But I don't believe he brought us this far. My husband said all the time, who died? Yeah. Nobody died that we were connected to. Yeah. Because nobody died is hope. Yeah. It's hope, y'all. Yeah. It's hope. And now I look forward to going shopping. What woman doesn't want to go shopping? You know, we took you for your birthday and we did a little shopping, but girl, you better get ready. And I couldn't let him see me cry, because I'm the strong one. Yeah. Many people don't know, but I'm Big Swole. They call me Big Swole. I tell you, it's a long story. But Big Swole don't cry. But I had a moment, and God said, you're human. Yes. Yes. You're human. You know, we act like we can't cry sometimes, but we're human. And I thought about all the effort and all the work and everything we put into making our building beautiful for the Lord. And I just said, God, you got something greater. Yeah.